Welcome to Vlog 50! So this week's been all about the cabaret. I saw five of them. No plays, two musicals, and five cabarets, or small concerts, as you might like to call them. I don't really know what the difference is. I think officially, with a cabaret, you get food. I didn't get any food. So maybe there were small concerts. Anyway, they were brilliant. More about them later.
Welcome to vlog 50. I can't believe it. I've got to 50. 50.
I don't know. I can't count.
Who would have thought, hey? What do you get for 50?
Gold.
Got it. Anyway,
on Monday, I was back at the Other Palace for the continuation of their series New Year, New Favourites, produced by the incredible partnership Lambert Jackson Productions. And on Monday, it was the return of the formidable Steph Parry. Steph is an old chum of mine who loves to do a cabaret. Although last year, she joined the cast of Mamma Mia! The Party at the O2 and hasn't been able to do as many cabarets. True to form, Steph rattled through 13 songs without any guests, apart from Ben Papworth, her incredible musical director. She mixed up the evening with a few classic musical theatre songs and a few of her trademark rewritten versions, which she loves to do. Steph is hilarious and is very stagey. Stagey. She'll kill me for saying that. But she loves musical theatre and I love her for it. As well as singing The Winner Takes It All, which you'd expect from Steph, she also sang the incredible Me and the Sky from Come From Away and sounded amazing. And she sang one of the songs from the Adrian Mole musical called Perfect Mother. Here are a few clips from Steph's evening.
She's messy, but she's kind. She is good, but she lies. She is hard.
Find all those videos on my YouTube page. It was so nice to catch up with Steph, who is looking incredible. She was wearing this gorgeous blue jumpsuit that was made for her for Mamma Mia the Party, but had been rejected. So she got to keep it. And her hair is looking fine. She's bang tidy. Can I get away with that? On Tuesday, I went to watch the cast change of Everybody's Talking About Jamie with this little superstar, Noah Thomas. Noah is a third-year student still training at Mountview who was auditioned and won this coveted role as Jamie, making his West End debut before he'd even graduated. Incredible. And those were some big stilettos to fill. I've seen this show four times, first with John McCrea, and then twice with Luke Bayer, and then with Leighton Williams last year. Leighton is now going on tour with the show, leaving the show in the very capable hands of Noah Thomas. He is an absolute superstar in the making. His voice is incredible and his comic timing is brilliant, which this role demands. He also beautifully plays the vulnerability of the character as well, and it all comes together magically. Joining him for a second year is Bianca Del Rio in a role that she has really made her own. Bianca, obviously, we all know from Drag Race. But what you don't know about Bianca is how great a singer she is. And a very good actor. And Roy, as he is really called, seems at home on this stage in this production. Melissa Jacks, who now plays Margaret, originally understudied the part last year and is exceptional. And I love to see understudies snatch those roles back because she really, really deserves it. Sejal Keshwala has stayed on to play Ray and is brilliant. If anything, completely underused, she gets one song and it's not even a great one. But she is exceptional. More about her later in the blog. David O'Reilly and Leon Craig join James Gillian, who has stayed on since the original production in Sheffield. Now, David O'Reilly was recently in The Book of Mormon and is brilliant. So funny. And Leon Craig, who I recently saw in Panto in Wimbledon, is superb. Taking over from the part played by Vinegar Strokes, who was recently in Drag Race UK, Leon slips into this character perfectly and is brilliant. And making her long overdue West End debut is Heba Aishaik. She is stunning. She played Jasmine in Aladdin in Australia, but this, remarkably, is her first West End show. And she is perfect as Pretty Pasha. Her voice is gorgeous. Everybody in this cast is brilliant. And it's testament to a show like this that it can continue to thrive and do well each cast change. Every time I revisit this show, I wonder when they're going to drop the ball. Every year, they just get the casting right. And this show is superb. The producers threw on some drinks and pizzas after the show, which was lovely, and I totally broke my diet. Thanks. Honestly though, if you've not seen this show yet, now is the time to go, because Noah is going to be huge, and you'll have seen him here first.
Thank you. 2020, bitches!
On Wednesday afternoon, I was invited to the press lodge of Be More Chilled, the new show that's coming to the Other Palace later this month. And I also got to chat to a few of the cast. Now, this was a brilliant event where press were invited to watch three songs from the show and to meet and interview some of the cast. And it was lovely to catch up with a few of them.
I wish I had the skill to just be funny, cool and chill.
What were you like at school?
Jeremy. Did you just see me? I mean, so similar. Like me. Jeremy is me.
And I think I'm probably the Jenna. I was just kind of floating around everyone.
Like, I definitely like was like a floater of friendship groups. But I don't think I spread as many rumours as she did, so...
I was not as much of a sort of musical theatre nerd as I would like to be. I felt like I missed out, actually.
I was the worst. No, I had a mullet. I had a massive scab and a mullet.
On Wednesday, I was at the Other Palace for Sejal Keshwala's own solo show. Taking a night off from Everybody's Talking About Jamie and leaving behind her Devolution girls, she put together her own show. And she was brilliant. I didn't realise how funny she is, as well as being a world-class singer. Keeping with Everybody's Talking About Jamie, she brought in one of her guests, Sabrina Sandhu, who played Pretty Passion last year. And together, they sang a little Jamie mashup. She was also joined by Andrew Bateup for a beautiful rendition of My Funny Valentine. And the extreme vocalist, Evie Rose Lane. The vocals on these ladies is ridiculous. And Sejal gave us a show like no other and looked stunning in this beautiful sparkly green dress. I could honestly listen to her sing all day long. Yeah. Here are a few videos from the evening.
So this is what it feels like to match with someone that you love, what the hell is the catch? It's the feeling of freedom of seeing the lights burn, thank you with the key to kite. You see it, right? The conversation lasts 2 minutes, maybe 3 minutes. Everything we said in total agreement. It's a dream and it's a bit of a dance, a bit of a pause, a bit of a stand, a bit of a flip.
Again, you can find all those videos on my YouTube channel. On Thursday, I travelled down to Bristol to see Romantics Anonymous, this brilliant musical by Cumin and Diamond and Emma Rice, based on a French film, which I cannot pronounce. Now, I saw this originally in 2017 when it was performed at the Sam Wanamaker Playhouse. And I fell in love with it. It was a gorgeous, sublime production. Starring Carly Borden, who recently was in the Ghost Quartet at the Boulevard Theatre. She is one of only three actors to return to this new production, with six of the cast being brand new. Opposite her is Mark Antolin. He is dreamy. If you've ever seen him. Sorry, he is. The curly-haired Welsh boy was nominated for an Olivier for playing Seymour in Little Shop of Horrors at the Open Air Theatre last year. Or was it the year before? Anyway, he originally played a smaller character in this show and is now the lead and is brilliant. This show still has all the magic and charm from when I first saw it. And back then, it had Joanna Riding and Lauren Samuels in it, who have now been replaced by Laura Jane Matthewman and the formidable Sandra Marvin. The music is gorgeous, and it is quite a quirky little show, and typical of Emma Rice's style. Although it's set in France, all the actors within the show use their own regional accents, allowing for Mark to use his gorgeous Welsh tones. Now, this is being produced by Wise Children, which is Emma Rice's own production company, and she began redeveloping it this year. Now, it's only on at Bristol or Vic for 2 weeks, and then later in the year, it will go over to America. Which is a shame, because it needs to stay in the UK. Because I would love to see it tour the UK. And perhaps it will. I don't know what their plans are. And it definitely needs to come back to London. It was so nice to see this show again. And it was definitely worth the trip to Bristol, which actually isn't that far. And Bristol Old Vic is a beautiful theatre with exposed stone wall and some incredible, lovely staff. I'll definitely go there again. If you can get yourselves to Bristol by the end of this week, definitely go and check it out, because you will love it. And you get free chocolate. Theatre and free chocolate. What's not to love? On Thursday evening, I travelled straight back from Bristol to the Other Palace to see Declan Egan. I love Deck. He is so funny. For those who don't know him, shame on you. He is the boy from Oz who was in Jersey Boys in the West End and on tour, and has also toured with the Book of Mormon. And is brilliant. But what sets Declan apart is his humour. He is so funny. I saw one of his cabarets last year at Sejal, and I was definitely not going to miss this one. He just cracks me up. He was joined by some incredible guests, including Jamie Lambert, and the pair of them sang a cover of a Billie Eilish song, who has just swept the Grammy Awards recently. He was also joined by the gorgeous Georgi, who I adore. She is beautiful. And not to disappoint his Jersey Boys fans, he drafted in Dayle Hodge, Simon Bailey and Joe Maxwell for a little reunion and to sing Cry For Me. It was beautiful. He opened the show with a mashup of Larger Than Life and Hit Me Baby One More Time from the musical And Juliet. And I lost my shit. And then mixed up the show with a few more musical theatre songs and finished it with some Alanis Morissette. Nothing if not versatile. Anyway, Deck currently has no plans and is single, so if anybody would like to give him some work or date him, do get in touch. He'd really appreciate it. Here are a few songs from his evening.
With you,
I was an open freak in my heart.
I'm high, but I'm grounded. I'm sane, but I'm overwhelmed. I'm lost, but I'm pretty. Baby, what it all comes down to.
On Friday evening, guess where I was? That's right, the Ever Palace. This time for Natasha J. Barnes's evening. She is brilliant. Let's just get that out there. She was originally understudy in Funny Girl and took over the role when Sheridan Smith stepped back. Natasha is an exceptional vocalist and brilliant actress, despite never having trained. She was part of the original cast of Spring Awakening when she was quite young, in the West End. And since then, her career has just taken off. Her evening was brilliant, and she presented a few new songs from The Wicker Man and a new musical called Love Thing. And her guests were the incredible Vicky Stone, who is working on her new musical The Zoological Society, Joanna Woodward, who is gorgeous, and Gemma Knight-Jones, who gave us a little bit of Stevie Wonder.
Everybody's got a thing, but some don't know how to handle it. Always reaching out in vain, accepting the things not worth having. Don't you worry about a thing. Don't you worry about a thing.
Saturday evening, I was at the Other Palace for the final show in their New Year, New Favourite series. And this night belonged to Oliver Ormson. Who doesn't know Ollie? Better known as the other half of Carrie Hope Fletcher, he is a brilliant and gorgeous musical theatre performer who has been in the Book of Mormon, Cats, and most recently was in High Fidelity at the Turbine Theatre. He performed a couple of the songs from High Fidelity and brought back Joshua Diva as his special guest. He also brought out Sam Murphy. They were both in Cats together at Kilworth House. I was a little disappointed that they didn't give us Jellicle Ball. Instead, Sam performed This Love from Maroon 5. Ollie was brilliant and really does have an amazing voice. He finished the show with I Believe from the Book of Mormon. Here are a few videos from the evening.
I was so high, I did not recognize the fire burning in your eyes, the chaos that controlled my mind. Goodbye, she got on the plane, never to return again, but always in my heart. Oh, this love has taken its toll on me. She said goodbye too many times before, and her heart is breaking in front of me, and I had no choice, cause I won't say goodbye.
Oh, What? Why can't you be like me? Boss? Please, call me Mr. Springsteen. You know, with your top five breakups, why don't you get in touch with
him? Why would I?
Well, it's like in Bobby G.
When you call a girl up, but she's left town and you're pissed off that you didn't know about it.
That's right. Because I wanted to say goodbye and then I miss her. Wish you good luck. It's closure. And it's the same with your top five. Why don't you call like a ghost to roam the main street of the steel town where the plant's been closed since Veterans Day?
It from this week. A lot of cabarets and a couple of musicals and no plays. I must give a huge shout out to Lambert Jackson, who produced this entire series and allowed me to film all those videos that I uploaded. You should definitely keep an eye out for their future projects. They have some more shows coming up at the Other Palace, and they are also producing The Secret Garden at the Palladium with Jack Yarrow. Get in. Definitely go and check that one out. And if you're looking for more news, here is my 60-second roundup this week. Here is this week's 60-second roundup of theatre news. Magic Goes Wrong extends its run until the 30th of August. Meanwhile, the comedy about a bank robbery will close in May. Rachel Tucker will join Come From Away on Broadway from March the 3rd, after appearing in The Pirate Queen at the London Coliseum. Lucy Jones has announced that her upcoming show, Live at the Adelphi, will be recorded and released as an album. Mean Girls the Musical is being made into a movie and will transfer to the West End in 2021. Paul Merton and Rita Simons join the cast of Hairspray, and Michael Vincent will play Corny Collins 13 years after understudying the part. The actor musical production of the last 5 years at the Suffolk Playhouse will star Ollie Higginson and Molly Lynch. Love Never Dies, a sequel to Phantom of the Opera, will tour the UK later this year. Only Fools and Horses in the West End extends, and Sarah Bareilles finally won a Grammy after 7 nominations. Congratulations. Thank you for watching. I hope you've had a fantastic week. If you'd like to subscribe to me, please do. I always appreciate it. Don't want to beg, but please. And I will see you next week. Bye.